Alright, Henry Lee. Hello everybody, thank you for watching this channel. I'm Henry at Broken Arts. Today I'm going to do a couple of seals. The first one is for the family name seal for Japanese heritage family name Mitome. This family has inherited the last name from their ancestors, and we had a hard time to actually figure out what the kanji is. So eventually we choose these two characters for the sound, Mitome. It could be different kanji, but they got already lost track. If you are a Westerner, you want to use your English name or Western language name in Japanese language, there's another way to do that phonetically. I think you can try Google. They might the AI may help these days. Very convenient to ask everything. So this design is made on the computer first. I try to transfer it. Okay, sorry, it moved. I have to redo it. So that's why I have it print out. With multiple stamps for this purpose. And I use a liquid called the acetone, nail polish remover with an inkjet printer. Try to align in the center. This is a 1-inch stone. That's great. Okay. The Japanese language and Chinese language on the seal are the same. We use both seal script, and we don't use the kanas, right? Because the hands seal script is still used in both languages in the context of this name seal. And we also read the same way from left from right to left instead of from left to right. So the image on the stone is the mirror image. Let me show you the design. It's the final result we expect. So, okay. And here's the design. Yeah, you can see this is reversed. Right. Okay. So you can see more clear. And the seal has a sharp edge. We need to modify that to make it look vintage or antique. make it look like a thousand year old seal. So I round up the corners and the edge. You can randomly chip it. Originally, the chipping is desired as an authenticity mark because it's hard to duplicate. But these days, due to the printing or the technology, cameras and scanners, it's kind of hard to serve for that purpose. Okay, I think the camera is frozen. Oh, here we go. Okay, I try to cut some envelopes first before I touch the stroke. We cut between strokes first because the deepest part is these open areas. I just do the flooring. The background. Okay. That's it. The meaning of this three of this characters is three and to keep three generations to keep. Okay. I just interpreted it. It just meaning three keep to keep. Three just means multiple in general sense. Many. Okay. So I'm not ready to make a initial imprint. See how it looks like. Because this seal is hard, I need to put a rubber pad under it. Okay, that's pretty close. Because the stone is kind of like a relief, I need a slope to make the edge a little bit more softer or 3D kind of. So it's not as hard as a mechanical seal. Okay, let me just make a little bit adjustment in this whole area, this eye area. Just to make it a little bit, sometimes it has an expression I like. It's like a heart shape. I like it. So I'll keep it. It has a feel of the knife cut, you know, not like a brush writing stroke. That's not nice. So. The kanji in calligraphy also just for the records, so you can pass down generation after generation. Won't forget, the stone will last much longer than the piece of paper. But, let me see. So the standard script in calligraphy is a little different. Look like this. Well, actually, this is the if we write vertically, it will be this on top. This is same easy to as this so script is those horizontal dashes. Two mouths on top. Yeah, this cell script has more decorative variations, which is nice. That's why we kept using it, and it has more freedom of creation, because at that time the standard script does not exist. It's much older than this form, and let's see, I need to make just maybe a little bit. I think it's okay. Just a little bit extra here. Okay. I'll make a custom. Card. I've heard that they're using it for family business logo. So, oops, I don't do the logo, but this could be incorporated into a graphic design logo. Because I also provide the digital preview. It can be also easily transferred into graphic design. And you can just scan this imprint. Okay, this is a mirror image on the stone, so we need to make some nice imprints. Well, I will mark the orientation with my signature on the left side later. Now I have to check to eyeball it. Oops. I touched the paper accidentally. Hopefully, it will cover it. A copy for my record, my collection book here. And here you can see some recent works for Vietnamese heritage UK musician. And this is a Korean seal. I don't write Korean, but if you write your name in any language with a felt pen like this, I would be able to carve. You can see some are just symbols. And I did the one, I believe, is for Indian name. Let's see. Oh, here is a HKMO A or something. That's a you design I carve project, and many of those are Buddhist Dharma name for school. Now this is a unique seal I made from a custom provided stone. I do carve on stones you provide for a Buddhist master. And also this one. This is a huge stone. Okay, here we go. Put a pad underneath. I blow a little moisture to reduce the grain. My signature later. Thank everybody for watching. And if you need your own name seal, please follow the link in the video description, and we'll help you out every step of the way. If you know the size you need, you can just order. This is 1-inch stone, and the next one I'm going to do a quarter, 3/4-inch stone, which is the smaller. So stay tuned. The ink imprint will last a while before it dries up, so we'll put a blotting paper here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.